Okay. Good evening, and welcome to our spring 7th grade band concert. Feels nice to be able to say welcome to our spring concert, which means we probably had a winter concert, which means we've had two concerts this year. That's quite a change from last year in 6th grade. So thank goodness we're at a point in our lives when we can go back to some sense of normalcy with doing these types of events. So my name is Mr. Claussen, my colleague Mr. Bentz is back playing trumpet, that overlooking 7th grader back there, and sitting in and playing some trumpet because he just wanted to be conducted by me, I guess. So we're going to open our concert with a piece called Vortex. And when you think of a vortex, you think of a bathtub or a drain that drains slowly. And so there's this swirling, whirling type motion, and we're hopefully you'll be able to hear that in the music as we progress this. This is a student favorite, and we're glad to present this tonight. This is Vortex. Thank you. Dominican's kind of quality to it. It has a bit of a Central South American kind of quality to it. Very interesting piece, very challenging piece for us to do. Very impressive work, and I want to just feature or point out that the French horns did a smashing job. So please give it another hand. We'll continue our program with a piece that's near and dear to Mr. Bent's and my heart, and that's a piece called Earth Song by the great wind band composer Frank Ticelli. And he has been writing for a long time. He's written a lot of very, very, very challenging pieces for groups at all different levels. This would be probably his most accessible piece for a young band to do, and it's hard. And the level of difficulty of the stuff that he does goes all the way up into college and professional groups and beyond, and I've played some of his stuff, and it's really hard. So the challenges for us in this piece are the delicacy, the independence, the dynamic contrast that we have to do. It's slow. It takes its time to unravel and reveal itself. And as we think about our planet, our Earth, and all of the things that we've had go on in the last few years, this is really a testimony to us and to our planet. So we hope you sit back and listen and reflect and muse and get something out of Earth Song. We've worked very hard on this, and we're very proud of our presentation of it. So Earth Song. Thank you. traditions here at Falcon Ridge in our spring concert. We used to always try to find a pop piece, pop culture piece, pop music piece that the students can relate to, that they've heard. All three of the previous pieces, I don't think they probably go home and put their buds in and listen to Earth Song and go, oh, that Frank DiKelly, wow. Hey, have you heard this Frank DiKelly piece? They don't do stuff like that, do they? But they do watch movies. They do listen to film scores. And this is music from the really popular, really great movie called The Avengers. We hope you enjoy it. After we do this piece, there will be a short break while we bring the next band up to stage. And yeah, that's it. Thanks. Thank you. Okay, can we do the corral? Number two. Number two. All set? Corral two. E flat concert. One, two. Good evening. I think I've already said that before, haven't I? Welcome to the second half, the second portion of the spring 7th grade concert. This is a band that meets on white days during fourth hour. They have red floors, therefore they are called the Red Band. And we're going to open our program this evening with a piece called The Coastline Express, which is a story about a train along the coast. And it's an express train. Get it? It's a very, very fun piece. It's very exhilarating and exciting. It's got lots of short notes in it and lots of speed. And yeah, Coastline Express. Thank you.
turn to step on the podium. Hello, my name's Patrick Pence. I'm the other band director here at Falcon Ridge, and I'm here to lead you through the rest of the way for the Red Band's final three pieces. And the next piece is entitled Barbarossa, and presents a musical depiction of historical events stemming from World War II, when the Russian army successfully fended off an invasion of Russia by the Nazis during World War II. It's very famous and important events. And we started performing this piece before recent world events. And it led us to a very interesting discussion how the world is a very complicated and dynamic place, and that certain entities and certain powers and certain governments can go from being the hero in one situation to decades and over half a century later, being in a completely different position, and how things change over time, and how you have to kind of recognize the complicatedness of things, that things can't always be simple and you can't always think the same way about a certain part of the world or a certain country or a certain government or anything. It's all very complicated. But the events in this piece took place during World War II. This is a musical depiction of that entitled Barbarossa.
Thank you.
cut time, which was a new time signature for them, and has about 500 different tempo changes throughout the piece, and they executed every one of them marvelously. So we've been working really hard on that. So way to go. So our next piece, before we do our next piece, I want to you all to refer in your program to the last couple of pages. I want to draw your attention to them. The second to last page has information about summer band. We're going to have a ton of fun in August, playing really fun music with 7th and 8th graders at 12 o'clock on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays in the month of August. If you haven't signed up yet, you're missing out. It's going to be a ton of fun. You should be there. We're also offering individual lessons during the morning on those days as well, if you're interested, so you want to draw your attention to that. And then on the final page is a list of thank yous for all the different people, from custodians to teachers to our amazing administration, that make our jobs a lot easier. And man, and we can't do what we do without the support of an entire building full of faculty and staff and administration. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts to all of them. And also, I'm going to say this now so I don't forget, not that I would forget, but these students have just been a marvel and a pleasure to work with this year. Coming out of the pandemic and not having any concerts last year and doing half the year online, we were very pleasantly surprised at just the level of musicianship that both these bands have displayed. You wouldn't know that their first 2 years of band were marred with COVID and pandemic, because where they're at is right in line with some of the finer 7th grade bands we've had over the years that we've been at the school. And so really, really impressive, really fine work. And that doesn't happen in a vacuum either. And thanks to the parental support and all the encouragement you give at home. So to all those people, thank you so much. And then this next piece, if you're an 80s kid or a 90s kid like me, and those kids are getting a little bit older. I'm a little closer to 40 than I'd like to mention. We lived and died by the bicycle. The first time when the snow was melted enough that you could get out on your bike in the spring meant freedom. And you would get out on your bike and you might see your family at supper time. I remember the freedom I was given by my parents to ride around the neighborhood as long as I was home in time for supper. It was really a different era. And Springtime Ride comes to us by a local composer and educator, Erica Svano. She is a professor of music at Augsburg University in Minneapolis, and a product of my alma mater, University of Wisconsin-Eau Claire. And she uses that imagery in this piece, the first bike ride of spring, and also, because she's also an 80s kid, you'll hear sounds like if you grew up on the Goonies, or maybe even more recently if you watch Stranger Things, which kind of has that 80s old bicycle vibe. This harkens to that, and you'll hear sounds of that all the way through. This is a fabulous piece that we actually had a hand in commissioning when it was composed in 2017. Our school is part of a consortium that helped go towards the creation of this piece. Our name's in the score. It's kind of cool. It's a great piece. Erica Svano's Springtime Ride.
Thank you.
housekeeping. After our final piece, each seventh grader has been tasked with, after their instruments are away, coming back and helping us stack chairs and stands and helping us get the percussion back to the band room. You all can be a big help too. While that's happening, the custodians will wheel out racks for the chairs. If you'll let them get the first one on the rack, then if people want to help bring chairs to the racks, that'll be a huge help while we get the stage struck. And if everybody pitches in, we'll be out of here in no time. But before I do that, one final thing. I want you all to think about what you were doing 35 years ago. I was almost four. It was Mr. Claussen's first year of teaching 35 years ago. He was wrapping up his first round of concerts. Then think about what you were doing 26 years ago at this time. I was in eighth grade, and Mr. Claussen was wrapping up his first year at the brand new Falcon Ridge Middle School. If my parents hadn't moved, I would be sitting in these risers, and I would have been in his eighth grade band. And he's been here ever since, with one exception. And that was in 2011, when he took a sabbatical to be with his family for a year overseas. And I was lucky enough to be selected to be him for that year, and quickly found out just what big shoes those were, and I have big feet. And just amazing shoes to fill, and the team that he worked with during that time was amazing, and found out really quickly what it was like to be a part of a really amazing, high-functioning team, and his role in that. It was such a unique perspective, and then unfortunately he came back and wanted his job back, and so I had to go find another job for a few years until his two colleagues retired at the same time, and luckily they wanted me back. And that was in 2015, and we've been working together ever since. And it's just been an amazing ride throughout that entire time. And if you haven't heard from your children, Mr. Claussen is retiring at the end of this year. And this is his final concert. Like, this one, the seventh grade, like, this is it. So we were telling the students today just how special it was and just how grateful we were that this gets to be the last one, because they've been doing such an outstanding job. I mean, what a way to end a career and to put an exclamation point on things. And to work with Mr. Claussen, to be a student of Mr. Claussen, means that you're working with someone who has infinite patience, infinite kindness. You never will hear him get riled up or really worked up, or if you do, it's a very rare thing, and oh my goodness, there's probably a super good reason. A super calm demeanor. Lessons with him, even if you're just in for a quick 5-minute check, I don't think a single student has come out of a lesson not having gotten at least a little bit better. And it doesn't matter if you're going to go on and be the first chair of the all-state band in high school and the drum major of the marching band, or if you like to play in band and to hang out with your friends and you're working on your fingerings and your scales. And it doesn't matter where you were. He gives everybody all of his attention and all of his time, and he's so meticulous and he's so good at nurturing out in a very positive and encouraging way the best in students through high standards and through kindness and through positivity. And I could go on for a while, but I won't. To just say it's been an amazing time teaching with him these 7 years, and I think about just the tiny fraction of his career that I've been lucky to be a part of, and I can't imagine the other stories that his other colleagues over the years would have to tell about him. But it's been such a pleasure working with you. We're all going to miss you so much. We got some nice flowers from our friends at Schmidt Music.